Okay, hello friends. Now with the new one video, that is nothing but your SR conflict and RR conflict in LR0 parser explained with example. As we have seen LR0 parsing and how it works, how to perform or how to construct that table. There are columns. One of the column is action column, and we will enter values, that is nothing but the shift operation and reduce operation, because these operations on terminal. If state transitions on terminal symbol, then we are going to enter the values in action table on one of the terminal on which terminal symbol it is occur. So as you can see here, one example, that is I1 state and having production rule, or A tends to beta dot, okay, and it is having third production rule in your grammar. Consider, you just have to consider, this is the third number production rule in your given grammars, okay. And as you can see here, dot is on the rightmost position of production rule, so it is a final item, okay. It is a final item, and I2 is a state, and you are going to transit from state 1 I1 to I2 on which symbol? ID, okay. Consider these are the action table. As you can see here, it is a transition from I1 to I2 on symbol ID. So we'll write here in action table ID column, we'll write S2, right? That is your shift move, shift operation, because it is on terminal. But you can also observe that this I1 is having a final item, because dot is on rightmost position. So we have to perform reduce operation on I1 also. Means in first row we have to write reduce operation. So, and what is the production rule number? That is 3. It is a third number production in your given grammar. Consider, by considering any number you can give as an example here, but here we are considering it is a third number production rule. So what is the problem here again? As in LR0 parser, in action table, if you want to insert the reduce move, or if you want to perform the reduce operation, we are going to write R3 as this production number 3. We are going to write R3 in complete row having all the terminals, like here already shift operation we have written. So again we have to write this R3 and R3. But what happens here, as shift and reduce operation cannot be placed in a same column or same cell, we cannot write the both of the operation. That is nothing but your SR conflict, okay. Getting it is very simple. This is nothing but your shift and reduce conflict, shift operation reduce operation conflict, okay. Another one example A tends to B dot and B tends to ID dot, okay, both are the final items and having production rule number 2 and 3. These are the production rule numbers 2 and 3, okay, and this is the state I3. By considering, then what will be the entries in action table? Then action table only third number row. And this by considering terminal symbols like T1, T2 and T3. Okay, how we are going to write now? If we are going to perform reduce operation, because these are the final items, in row number 3, we'll write 2. That is first production rule. Production rule given having number 2 in I3, that's why we are writing R2. But what about the second production rule, that is having number 3? So same, both of the rules are having in available in same state. So we are going to write here again R3 and R3. This is nothing but RR conflict in LR0. This is nothing but RR conflict. Okay, hope you are getting the concept. In LR0, as you know, if reduce operation is there, we are going to write in complete row of action table, terminal symbols complete row, we are going to write that reduce operation. Okay, these type of operations or this type of actions are known as a SR conflict and RR conflict. This is about the LR0. Now we'll see the same concept with SLR1, with SLR1 parser. So how it works? Again, SLR1, you can see that same example we are taking, that is A tends to beta dot and it transit from one state to another, that is I3, by considering I3, this is I2, on ID we are moving, and as you can see, this is your final item because dot is on rightmost position and this is having third production rule number. Okay, production rule number. Okay, this is the three production rule number. What we are going to write then? Action table. In action tables, by consider terminals like ID plus and dollar, star, and this is your second I2. From I2, we are going taking transition to I3. Means from I2, it is going to I3. That is your second column. So shift operation will be there. That is nothing but your S3 on third. It is going to move or shift on third, but it is a final item. And in SLR1, we know that we are going to find out the follow of A, right? Whenever you want to perform reduce operation on final item, what we are going to do in SLR1? We are going to find out the, or we are considering follow of A, means on leftmost side, whatever the symbol is available, that symbol or that variable follow we are going to consider. And if that follow of A considering symbol ID, if it is there, consider if follow of A is having ID symbol, then what is the, we have to write R3 in ID column it only. What? Then we have to write R3, that is reduce operation, in ID column only, in second row. So this type of operation or action is known as SR conflict in SLR1. Second example or same example with another production rule, like A tends to beta dot and B tends to ID dot. Both are the final items and having production rule number 2 and 3. Okay, this is your I3, and follow of A, nothing but consider T1 comma T2, and follow of B, consider T2 comma T3. Okay, if we consider these values, what is, this is your I3 state and having production rules A tends to beta dot, means final item, B tends to ID dot, means final item, and having production rule number 2 and 3 in your grammar, given grammar. So follow of A and follow of B, as we want to perform reduce operation. So how your action table will work, or how your action table will look like? On third number row, you are going I3. That's why third number row we are going to consider only. Then consider terminals T1, T2 and T3. Okay, these are the terminals. So as we are going to perform reduce operation on A, okay, beta. So what are the follow of A, T1 and T2? We are going to write R2, because it is having second rule. Okay, in production given grammar, its number is 2. So we are going to write 2, R2 and R2 in T1, T2. It is a follow of A. afterwards follow up B, because second production rule is also final item ID and its number is R3. And what are the values? T2 and T3. So here T2 is having already filled with the R2. So again we have to write here R3 and R3. So this type of is known as RR conflict in SLR 1. This concept is known as RR conflict in SLR 1 parser. Okay, I hope all of you are getting how this type of parsing or conflicts like SR conflict and RR conflict in LR0 as well as in SLR0. With example, I have explained in very well and simple manner. I hope you are getting all this concept and it is very helpful for you in your examination. Thank you so much.